Fucking hey, oars.
Quite a smile. Like a royal wound.
Black ones for Damien's. Long as they
you
play.
You're a vulgar one. You can see it in your face.
You look fucking amazing.
You're back. Got the coin.
Here. That enough?
Hefty sack. Like a bull's. When do we sail?
Not sure you're ready. You can barely stand.
Know this, stranger. Captain Wolverston never sails sober. The sea goes one way, Wolverston the other. Makes the rocking bearable. So, ready to set sail?
Let's go.
First, we must drink to the wind, to good fortune, and to the strength of my Atropos. Anchors away!
Back off, or I'll kill you.
I'm not afeard of dying.
See, I've landed on Ard Skellig.
How you figure that?
You're wearing Clan on Crate colors. Ard Skellig's their island.
On the Atropos, were you?
Yeah. Thought the captain had a deal with you.
With us? Meaning who, exactly? Might have arranged something with Lugos, but crack. Nay. Clearly should have, though. Outlander ships aren't welcome in these waters. What about you? What do you seek in Skellige, eh?
Agreed to meet a sorceress here. Yennefer of Vengerberg. She's supposed to be on Ard Skellig.
There's a witch at Kertrolda. Croc's guest. Could be the one you're meeting.
That scorn I hear in your voice.
You've good ears. Folks say this witch got Croc wrapped around her finger. Orders everyone about. Word is she's vicious at it. But a hag's a hag.
Seen her? Know what the sorceress looks like?
Aye. Wears black and white. If not for her tits, you'd think she was a beached orca. Fact is, even those who see her for a wench would gladly push her out to sea, tits and all.
Yennefer's not all bad, once you get to know her.
Take your word for it. Know the way to Kertrolda?
Expect I'll find it.
Head north. Then turn west towards the bay before you come to the bridge. You'll find the Jarl portside today. Your sorceress ought to be there too.
Thanks. So long. Of power should draw.
Show me what you got.
Thank you.
We'll see. Find my 1,000 crowns back. That would be nice. Anyway. Unbelievable.
Are coming out of there. Best blow it up.
Come on.
Drowners are coming out of there. Best blow it up.
Nice view.
of our lads tried to kill that corson. Monster put luck in him. And our hero fled so fast he lost his cat.
That sheep shits in front of my wits.
Get away with me axe.
Why are you here?
What do you want from me? We need more time in the Isles.
Build your fortitude. What are you doing?
Wonder where they'll
go. Oh, they'll live at the bottom.
On the shore at Larvik.
Who are there?
Fierce caves.
You're looking for worms.
We've hewn the post.
Time for the chisels.
Must's got to be worthy of a conan.
Listen, Witcher. Got us some weird Yaeblen. You know, drowners. Real problem. The kind your silver sword could most certainly solve.
Let me guess. They're tearing your nets, devouring your fish, and attacking the occasional lone boatman or tavern patron who walks home along the shore.
Were that the only harm? Terrors in the bay are meaner than on the continent. They hunt come dusk or dawn. They attack fishermen wielding just oars and warriors alike. Sea tosses them up after. Armor shredded, guts devoured.
Strange. Any witnesses?
Rurik. My apprentice. He was on a boat the Muire Yaeblen attacked. There's Tove, too. Her man was killed. She lives nearby, up a bit. Sorry, none of it comes to mind. Those who see the beasts, meet him, well, they generally don't come back to dry land alive.
Let's talk about my pay first. Bit too modest for my taste.
That's dear, it is. But could be worth it. All right, I'll pay you what you want.
I'll take the job. Dealt with drowners many times. It'll soon be over. Got my word on that. Rurik, right? Heard you were on a boat the drowners attacked.
Aye, I was. With Ulf, my cousin, gathering our crab traps off the Kerrig cliffs. Ulf was pulling up a line, having a hard time of it. You know, grand, I thought. Cage has got to be full, it'll be a good haul. Then something tugged back and down. Weren't it? Called after him, once, twice, thrice. Then the water went red with blood. I smelled something horrid. Rotten, but worse. In the Muir, the Yaeblen flipped the boat. Don't even know how I made it ashore. Must have had Freyr watching over me.
That, or the monsters had eaten their fill. Thanks for the story.
Ah!
Can't I play today, Dad?
You've got to go to the port. Bid farewell to King Bran. It's not fitting to play at.
I will be King of Skellig and all.
I know that. But the gods will make sure to be one word.
Are you Tove? I was told drowners killed your husband.
Then you were told right. First the sea took me son, and now me man. I'm the only one left. Kivilla, our son. He went out fishing and didn't come back. My man would walk out to the Kierag cliffs every day to watch for his boat. I told him he cannot bring him back to life, and that he could die himself. We'd heard about drowners. One night, he didn't come home. I fetched me brother, grabbed a torch, and we went looking for him. The Muire Yaeblen, sea fiends. They'd caught him so bad, I only knew him by his coat.
Small comfort, I know. But the drowner problem will soon end. I promise you.
The sea is a source of endless riches for the inhabitants of Skellige. It offers up a near-endless bounty of fish, birds, and ambers. The village at the foot of Caer Trolde, for example, found itself plagued by some particularly aggressive drowners. The local shipbuilder promised Geralt a reward if he could solve this problem for them. Geralt, for whom killing drowners was as simple and effortless as relieving his bladder, was certain he goes in for some easy coin.
Their victim.
Down.
prisoners for sure. Lair must be nearby. Must be near the fishing ground Rurik mentioned. That stench. Drowners for sure. Lair must be nearby. Again, slime and rotting flesh. Drowners.
Let's clear this.
piece of armor falling apart in my hands. Monster's lair, but definitely not a drowner's. Bruises on his neck, crushed larynx, strangled. Unbroken, but the marrow has been sucked out. Need a long, thin tongue for that. Almost untouched. Hidden for later. Drowners just don't do that. Bruises on his neck. Crushed larynx. Strangled. Bits of boats. Torn sails. Lines. Sailing decor, you could call it. That stench. The marks on the bodies. This must be a water hag's lair. Got a keen sense of smell. She won't come back while I'm here. Unless... she coexists with drowners. Maybe I could make an extract from their glands, cover up my scent. That should do it. Now for a place to hide and wait. Behind those boats.
Below, Kertrolde had a pernicious reputation. At times, fishermen who chose to cast their nets in its waters would never come home again. Something would drag oarsmen off their longship, or knock the ships themselves over. The locals blamed this on sea devils, the Skellige's name for drowners. The truth, however, proved far worse. A water hag had made her lair in the caves beneath the cliffs of Kierak, an old and experienced water hag, with powerful claws able to demolish any attempt to block or parry, and the ability to blind opponents from a distance, then strike with a lightning-quick counterattack. Signs would be needed to best her. Irden to slow her, Gwen to protect. Needed most of all, however, would be a great deal of luck.
Job's done. Here's the proof.
Now why would I want to see... What the devil's that?
Water Hag. An old, clever one. She was the danger.
Seen a lot of ugly critters in me life. Moorays, lampreys, blobfish. But never nothing like this. Your reward. Well earned, Witcher. Well earned.
Thanks. So long.
Stay on. My home is your home.
And ugly as a sea devil.
Wait for man in need.